Now let's take a closer look at skin diseases, disorders, and conditions. Persons with boils, infected wounds, open sores, or abrasions, or weeping dermatological lesions should avoid working where there is a likelihood that they could contaminate healthcare supplies, body art equipment, or working surfaces. Workers' skin should be free of rash or infection, and healthcare workers, tattoo artists, and caregivers should cover any sores with bandages to avoid the potential spread of disease. Skin is one of the best defenses we have against infectious diseases, and I think it's important that we take a look at the anatomy of the skin. See, skin is the largest organ of the body. It contains blood vessels, sensory receptors, nerves, and sweat glands. It's made up of the epidermis and the dermis, and it varies in thickness from about 1.5 to 4 millimeters or more. Skin is the first line of defense against infection. Now, the epidermis is the thick outer layer of the tissue, and the dermis is the strong, flexible second layer of connective tissue. The dermis is filled with blood vessels, and unclean tattooing or body art is a high-risk activity for blood-borne pathogens because it involves multiple punctures of that skin. And when we put the pigment under the skin, it goes into the actual lower dermis levels, which is completely unprotected from disease. Hypodermis is just below the skin. It's the fatty layer, also called the subcutaneous layer. There are three commonly spread skin diseases that we should mention, and we're going to break them into bacterial, viral, and fungal. The first one, bacterial, MRSA, MRSA, otherwise known as methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus. Infection can look like an ordinary skin wound, a boil, or an infected sore. Highly contagious. Now the second type, viral, we're going to look at herpes simplex. Now generally, it's found on the face, the scalp, arms, neck, and upper chest. It's indicated by small round blisters, and when they're broken, can secrete a clear or a yellowish fluid. People contract herpes by touching the infected yellowish fluid and then spreading it to non-intact skin, mucous membranes, or other areas of their body. The last, fungal infection, most popularly known as athlete's foot or ringworm. It can cause red, patchy, or flaky, itchy areas. It is contagious and is easily spread from one person to another. It spreads when infected areas on another person or contaminated surfaces are touched, and then the affected areas really should be kept clean and dry, and in many cases, you probably need to get a medication that is an antifungal to finally rid yourself of that infection. Now, some people with the following conditions are more prone to skin disorders. Healing may be adversely affected by receiving tattoos or body art. A history of hepatitis B or hepatitis C, HIV, or actually the autoimmune deficiency syndrome, diabetes, a history of hemophilia or any other blood disorder or disease, a history of a skin disease or skin lesions, history of allergies or adverse reactions to pigments, dyes, latex, etc., or other autoimmune disorders.